What's up? It's your boy DFW Exclusive, the one and only, the Don One, Don Callion over here. You know what I'm saying? Who we got on this beat?
We with the Double L Mafia, you hear me?
Yeah.
Real shit.
I always want to ask you this shit. What is the Double L shit? Where did it come from?
Alright, that's some shit we just... Shit came out of nowhere type shit. Like, we was in college, we went to school. Out there in TSC. Yeah. Start hustling and shit. Said my brother talking about, they might as well call me Double Up Youngster.
Yeah.
That have clicked in my head. We can Double Up from now on. Like, that's them. And we snapped that shit. And my mama and Tyler for shit show. Like, that have ring bells for shit show.
Nah, like you say, you had went to college, but like I say, what rapper was that? I think his name was B King. I was at one of his performances. He was like, you ain't no real step or no real gangster if you went to school. And I personally feel like school don't define none of that shit. What are your thoughts on the shit, on that type of shit?
As far as me, shit, look, it's naughty. That street, that gangster shit, that shit ain't cool. Nigga trying to on the bigger and better things, hear me?
Like,
I ain't worried about what no nigga say. I went to Burlington in high school for the last 2 years. My mama with the white people, adapted to the white people.
That shit kind of nigga said adapted.
I was really supposed to be playing. I had a scholarship at Texas State. I was really supposed to be playing football, but a nigga caught a fed me.
Yeah.
Shit. From where it went, but shit, I luckily backed out in the TJC.
Oh, you caught a fed me.
Yeah.
Damn. Well, shit, without, I wouldn't say go into detail, but without going into detail, like,
I don't even matter.
What happened with this shit? Like, how the fuck that shit come about?
Shit, me and my partner, we. Shit, long story short, shit. We get pulled over with some work in the car.
Yeah.
All the way in the country in Joshua.
Oh, yeah, you fried.
Yeah, my partner, he on the run. He tell me, looked at me, he say, hey, bitch, I'm finna run. I said, go do your thing. But shit, he already had my ID and shit when he said so. Shit, it was no point. Shit, he ended up getting away. He skated for like 6 months. And that's why I had a felony because they were pinning all the shit on me. But shit, he finally got caught up with some little bitch. He called me from jail. He was like, hey, bitch, my lawyer tell me if I claim half of it, you claim half of it, they gonna slap us on the wrist. I say, bitch, say less. Shit, I did that. He did that.
Well, so you took that on some real, like on some Roddy and Bobby Shmurda type shit. Damn. A lot of niggas wouldn't do that though. I ain't gonna lie to you. I salute you for that, cause a lot of niggas would have, you know what I'm saying? A lot of niggas would have folded under the situation, under the pressure. Like,
we ain't doing none of that.
Now, not to cut you off, but like, with you being like a real nigga, like, you know what I'm saying, stomp down on what you believe in and shit like that, how the fuck that transition to like your music?
Like,
that is the music.
Yeah.
That shit come right out of nigga.
That is the music.
No pen, no pad. That shit come right out of
them. Oh, you be freestyling?
We freestyle.
Way out the door.
You know a question coming next, dog. Let me go ahead and get one of them. Let me go ahead and get some hot shit.
Alright.
He said, alright. I try to hit some hot shit, man. I ain't gonna lie, cause a lot of rappers, I don't freestyle, all right. You know what I'm saying? So.
Damn, we ain't got no speaker, none of that shit. It's just a random beat type shit. We don't. It's more crazy when the whole mob together, though, for real.
Oh, so this not all of y'all?
I don't know.
Oh, y'all deep?
Man, this is just, damn, and we all be on that music shit. The squeeze is finna pull up right now.
So before I even ask you the next question, like on some for real shit, like on some mental shit, like as far as your circle, like, cause like you see, like a lot of niggas get backdoored and they shit, like, not even to bring up a lot of niggas, but like niggas, like, for instance, they say J-Dub Homeboy end up backdoing them, shit like that. Niggas getting, you know what I'm saying? Like, how do you keep it to where like your circle is deep like that, but everybody just click tight,
like
how y'all go
through this? Man, we, for one shit, we grew up together, and the niggas that didn't grow up with us recognized really just fell in place.
Yeah.
And shit, we treat everybody equal, like real, like shit. it gotta be a bond to be part of the mob. Like, they know, oh, he popping, he could be in the mob. Oh, man, fuck that shit. There's a lot of niggas who could be in the mob that's popping right now. But we stand down. We trying to build the shit from the ground up, literally.
Yeah.
No major platforms, no promotion, nothing. My mixtape did 6K in 3 months. I'll say that's good for me.
Hey, yeah, especially
wait till I get that exposure. They gonna be all on my dick, nah, for real. Look, I'm gonna still kick some shit for you real quick. Hold on. I don't know you can hear this out. You can't hear this out right. But I've been on some other shit, trying to make it double quick, trying to make the double rich, trying to make the mob tie, trying to tie the knot. I'ma tie the knot up in this bitch. I got my stick in this leak. And I'm lit. Came with them sticks and we snuck it in the 40 Glock. Yeah. 40 Glock, 45. Yeah. And you know we'll go live.
Yeah.
CIP Latide, CIP Murder Cake, put it in their face.
Nah, for real.
Talk it each and every day, put it in their face.
Yeah.
Yeah. These niggas can't relate. Real gon' recognize real. I pop me a pill. I might pop me a pill. Get the rolling like for real. Get the rolling like a nigga nickname Will. Damn. The bitches, they just wanna come and fuck with a jump of the thrill. No bike. I'm on a moped. I pull up on a moped. Sir that. What you need? Yeah, I got that. Work back. Get the work back. We're gonna go back to the trap house with the trap back jump.
Yeah.
The D. Now back in the funk.
Yeah.
And you know I'm up to something. Counting up Monday through Sunday, counting up Sunday through Sunday, talking about 24-8, come from the side of the 8, you know we do it great, hey, you know we do it great.
Yeah.
Hey, hello. Nah, this is some light shit, I can't even give too much, no cap.
Let me say I can't give too much.
You gotta get the mob together, it's a vibe with us, you hear me? Like, it's we need niggas to tune in, yeah. Like for real, that got squeezy right there. See, if I turn, boy, we'll do this shit for hours. Juice WRLD who? That nigga ain't got
that
shit.
That nigga
on.
Said Juice WRLD who? That's, I like the confidence, but damn, that nigga said Juice WRLD who? Shit.
I feel like, for one, we out rapping niggas.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna let that be known.
That nigga said Juice WRLD who?
We out rapping niggas.
Damn. So what y'all projects looking like?
Shit, we got mob ties coming. 22 songs.
Damn, this is an album, then?
Bro, man.
A mixtape with 22 songs?
You see this shit? Like,
that's enough for two mixtapes.
Fuck two mixtapes. These all songs, bitch.
Damn.
These all songs.
Shit.
Stop playing.
Oh, that nigga.
Two mixtapes. That's not even all of them.
Damn.
Scrolling for days.
I was
just 128 items in that. I dividend that into about 10. Man, when I told these niggas I could drop a mixtape every month for 2 years right now and not even touch a studio.
But I don't understand why rappers do that or artists do that. I ain't gonna call you a rapper because anybody can be a rapper and not be an artist. You know what I'm saying? I'm saying as far as like hold their music and not drop it. Like, niggas be having so much unreleased heat that they let me hear it. And I'm like, bro, why you ain't dropped this shit? This shit could be the shit that take you to the top.
It could, yeah, but it's all about timing. You gotta do it in timing, bro. I could drop shit all day, but niggas act like they gonna stroll by, act like they don't see that shit. All in their motherfucking face, but I'm gonna put it in their fucking face, you know?
And this is what you call it, Squeeze, right?
Yeah.
Oh, this Squeeze.
Yeah.
Oh, shit, I thought that was Squeeze. Damn.
Nah, this DC. He route too. He MCF though, but he mob tied for real. This shit's up. We dropped that body for body. That hell did like what? 4K.
Oh my god.
That was some slight no promotion. Like I said, on film that mic when he wasn't buzzing.
Yeah.
Heard a lot of that, bro.
Hold on. This hell.
Dropping in December.
Yeah.
Facts. Yeah. We ain't got an official date yet, but it's dropping in December for shit. So
yeah.
20 songs plus, all guaranteed bangers, you hear me?
Yeah.
Straight drop.
We go verses for verses with any rapper in the city, and then y'all tell me what y'all think.
All right, so let me ask you this. Like, for the I kind of asked this kind of like a general question on some shit, because a lot of rappers that have talent, they don't really kind of like, they don't really blow like that. Versus the niggas that really, in my opinion, they don't be as good as the niggas that got, that don't have the talent or don't have the recognition, but them niggas just got the clout with the shit. Like, what do you feel you got to do to kind of like blow?
Look, shit, I don't know what you got to do to blow, shit. I'm trying to do everything to blow, you hear me? But, shit, I fuck with Pulo, Bumpy Jackson on Hood. Well, he always told me, on God, when I first started rapping, he's like, hustle gonna outbeat talent.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, shit, you got to put that shit in their face. Like, niggas really don't be putting that shit in their face because niggas really don't be trying to, they don't be listening. They just, oh, that JQ rapping, blah, blah, blah. Nah, niggas, dumb Dario.
No.
Like, pay attention to what I'm saying. These niggas not fucking with me.
But how long you been rapping though?
Free that nigga, Young Cuckoo. He gotta send that bitch first. Right?
Young Cuckoo got me in the stool first. Shit,
I was say Young Cuckoo.
Free Young Cuckoo. Playing shit.
Tell you.
That's, what? That's a lot.
A lot.
this some motherfucking, I don't even know where that that's some 100 gang shit. Nah, for real.
Young Cuckoo,
man. That nigga say Young Cuckoo. I ain't never. That's a unique ass nickname. What the hell?
Man, nigga, you cuckoo at you. This is stuck.
Man, look, we on the topic of talking about how you. When you say how you blow or some shit.
How it blows.
Look, I'm finna talk about some Fort Worth shit. Cause in Fort Worth, you gotta be. This is what people doing for work.
A lot of niggas crash out doing dumb shit to blow.
It's not but it's not even just that, bro. People, but this how you blowing for work. You gotta. The city gon' dick ride whoever is popular to dick ride.
Yeah.
Like a perfect example, my nigga Tyreek, 1K Teezy.
Yeah.
Bro,
oh, you know 1K Teezy?
Yeah, Tyreek, that's my nigga. Like, bro, been hard.
One of the oldest niggas in the city.
He's just not getting a little recognition, too.
No, look, this is what it is. At first, it wasn't popular to support, bro. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't a thing to do. That's what Fort Worth do. Whoever they see what everybody else doing, what's cool to do, that's what they gonna do.
Yeah.
So now that they seeing bro taking off, he getting a buzz, now everybody trying to get, but that's just how Fort Worth do, bro. If you ain't, I don't know, if you ain't beefing with some niggas, they want to hear beef. If you ain't beefing with no niggas, or you ain't on other shit, they not gonna really like tap in for real, because it be niggas in the city. Half of these niggas that be on the list, I don't even be knowing
bro,
these
I was
niggas.
Just finna say, bro, this nigga, who dropped it? And the real tune dropped the list. Like half them niggas, I didn't even know was from this show.
Man, yeah, but it's a real big pay to play factor.
Nah, but the mob though, we kicking down that door. For sure, we gonna kick down that door. Yeah. We gonna make our way for this show. That's them.
And nigga really don't condone in beef. We handle that shit instantly. Like you ain't gonna never hear about me beefing in the city, none of that shit. Like
yeah. Cause God. In my opinion, beef a broke nigga sport. That's how I look at this shit. Cause niggas ain't getting no money.
Shit.
If you got time to beef.
But shit, you can't let no nigga play with your name.
Yeah, no doubt.
But some beefs be real though. You know what I'm saying? Some beefs be legit. Now it'd be a lot of bullshit, but you know what I mean? You take one of mine, you know what I mean? You score one, you know what I mean? I get it. But, you know what I mean? But that's what niggas using to pop because people like.
I ain't gonna lie, niggas do a lot of name dropping or ooh, why. Like, and a lot of niggas, you see a lot of niggas around the city, they diss on the dead to get a lot of clout too. Like, how you feel about the dissing on the dead shit?
Look,
I respect it if you was dissing a nigga while he was alive.
What's
if it's fucking when he alive, it should be fucking when he dead. It shouldn't change.
Yeah.
But if you weren't talking about the nigga when he was living, and then the nigga died, and all of a sudden it's fucking.
And then niggas get the rapping like they the ones that done did
that. I ain't really heard too many niggas diss on my brother. You hear me?
Nigga ain't gonna diss, man.
Nigga
say,
not dissing. The only nigga who done dissed on one of my brothers. Hold on. The only nigga that done dissed on one of my brothers is that how that nigga, he talking about some fuck Murder K and one of his shit.
When the fuck he say this?
He said something. He said something in one of them hoes. Like, it ain't even no tension, no beef with that nigga. But like, shit, like.
Nah, hell
you gotta
nah.
See about that. You gotta
see
see about that. Like, damn, what's up, bro?
When the fuck this nigga? Like,
But that's just that beef shit though, like that east side, south side beef shit. You know what I mean? Like so, like a nigga gonna say it could be a nigga that a random ass nigga we ain't never seen or never heard of on the south side talking about fuck Murder K. You know what I mean?
Nah,
like,
nigga ain't. I ain't gonna lie.
But best believe on Crip, ain't no nigga gonna disrespect nothing in our face. On Crip,
nigga, that shit. Hell nah. So what's up? So you and Yayo done got like y'all done had words over this shit or like
nah
or it
nah,
never
nah,
just
nah.
it never managed
nah,
to
nah, nah. my nigga the real gambler in Texas. My nigga Squay was hitting it was some little petty change, it was just some little bullshit. They were hitting all the YTN niggas. Then get my little running child come in, Squay just clear him out quick. But not on
the That's supposed to be the best gambler in Texas though.
Man, we just off a song, we on them 211s. What I just tell you earlier.
That nigga said 211. Yeah, I need to kick them hard. Y'all did well.
Shooting, but shit.
Shout out to that nigga.
Nigga tried to play on the dice. It's only me and Squee. Like, we there by ourselves. They deep in the hole. But they talking about some, what happened? Shit, some, they tried to play nigga on the dice. Nigga ain't going out like no hoes. It wasn't like shit. My nigga Zaytoni, Free Zaytoni, he did a song with Pooh Bear after that shit.
No, we locked in Pooh Bear, like them. I'm from the South Side, Pooh Bear. That's them my niggas.
Pooh Bear fucking my but shit, double up nigga youngster.
Yeah, we that shit ain't no shit like that.
Weird
shit.
Well, I didn't been in the store with Chucky.
We got the mob tape coming soon, 2022. Mob tape coming soon.
We already got shit out on all platforms. Go tap into some real shit. Y'all be fucking.
So y'all done dropped the album together yet? Or
nah, the mob. That's what's gonna be dropping. Everybody.
Nah, but we got before all that though. We dropped. We gonna get some more visuals and shit. Yeah,
that's what's and important. Right?
Some more visuals, you know what I'm saying?
My shit, Quaylen shit. With all the niggas coming January.
Shit,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? More visuals. He trending right now. And, right. You know what I'm saying? You got a couple more niggas. Half Price still doing this shit. You know what I'm saying? We gonna get some more visuals out, and then shit. Then we gonna drop the tape with everybody. But we all are separate artists though. We all got our own, but we together though. Like, you know what I'm saying? We all together. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Everybody in the mob gonna have a mixtape out.
Yeah. It's a Love and Pain coming in January.
So hold on, let me ask all y'all this: How y'all feel about not seeing yourselves on the list? Like, do y'all even care about that shit? Or like, how y'all feel about
that? We ain't really just being active like
everybody
that.
Everybody on the list.
No, just, I'm just saying, like, the list they be dropping, like, y'all not seeing y'all names.
But that's what I was saying earlier. Like, it's a pay-to-play sport, my nigga. It's niggas on that list that are paying to be on them lists. Niggas ain't just popping up randomly on them lists.
Nah, fuck all that.
Niggas paying to be on the list. I don't even pay to be on nobody's shit.
Bro, who you know on that list? Like, besides the people that we know, like, who you know on that list?
Right.
Imagine me spinning
this minute. It be niggas on that list I ain't never seen in Fort Worth a day in my life.
Bro, I was just finna say that shit, nigga. I seen niggas. I ain't never even knew these niggas were rapping.
Never seen these niggas on my mama.
So how do you think they end up on the list?
Well, now that you put it like that, niggas is dropping that bag to get on the list.
I don't know, but I'm just asking. Why do you think
that? I don't think niggas is paying to get on the list.
I didn't say every nigga paid to get on the list.
But see though, look, check this out though. If I don't know you as a rapper, you be like, hey, I'll pay you to put me woo woo at such such spot on the list.
That don't make.
I mean, that do make sense.
You gotta pay to play.
It kind of do.
Yeah, like, what the fuck? You gotta pay to play.
I'm pretty sure if I hit one of them niggas up and be like, hey. I got a band right now. Put me number 5 on the list.
Put me somewhere.
That's going to create a bunch of controversy. Well, niggas don't want to go to your page and see
really,
what you...
Really, bro.
Exactly. So, I mean, it's really a marketing scheme, too, though.
Yeah,
it's a networking scheme.
Of course.
That's what our blogs is. Like, you know what I'm saying? They create controversy.
But when
what it is, clout.
But when that It Just Love and Pain drop, I'm fucking going to be on that list after It Just Love and Pain
drop. Damn.
So, let me hear something.
I'm singing on it. I'm singing on it, bro. You know what I'm saying? They got to tune in when they come out.
You gotta give them something slight for the camera.
Not even a whole fool, you know what I'm saying? Just give me a little sneak peek.
Alright,
and
y'all got a sober, Quay, not a drunk.
Alright, I got you. I am head over heels for you. All love laced up like a shoe. Can't love no one else but you. Believe me when I say that I'm in love with you. Crazy love for you. Shit, I forgot the rest. But you know, it's just love and pain, man. It's just love and pain.
That's like sixth grade Quay.
A whole lot of love shit, a whole lot of slug shit. We got both
types
of shit.
Keep in mind, that's sixth grade Quay.
A whole lot of that.
It's just love and pain. Y'all made it. That was. Y'all was doing that one. That's a song from back when I was like 10.
Oh, that was from old
11.
We was singing to bitches on the phone and shit.
So quick question, back to you. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, a lot of niggas don't know that, but a lot of rappers that I bring on my channel, like, I done known them niggas for years. Like, me and you, we go way back to, like, 5th, 6th grade. That dude right there too. So it's like,
I remember before I even knew this nigga on hood, we was in like sixth grade talking about this nigga Alizé 17 in sixth grade. Nigga ain't 17.
Nah, but like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I done known a lot of y'all, like you, him, you know what I'm saying? Unfortunately, we didn't, you know what I'm saying? Well, I'm glad to have met him before his passing, but Todd, you know what I'm saying? I done met a lot of y'all before then. So kind of like, speak on like, from then till now, like growing up, and then you see like, your partners like, that you ain't with no more, like, man, not even on no disrespectful shit on my end, but like, how that shit feel?
That shit bittersweet. It feel good for all your accomplishments, but it also feel, damn, like my nigga ain't here to share that shit with you. You know what I mean? Yeah. But
that shit will come with it, though. Like, that shit will come with everything. Like, especially life in the murder. Like, we in the murder zone.
She
like,
can
you
fall
know what
down
saying?
Any day of the week, for real.
Any day of the week, any time of the day. Any, just anything. Damn.
You never know.
But see, the only reason I kind of brought that shit up, because like I said, I know Todd a long time, too. So it's like, you know what I'm saying? Seeing that shit happen unfold, like.
We rode the bus together from the Valhalla's to the,
Ah, niggas don't even know about, they don't even know about the boat. No
we
cap.
Was on, and I'm going to just go ahead and clear this up. We was the first niggas terrorizing the Southwest Side, literally.
Yeah, because I ain't going to lie. Southwest Side used to be a goddamn safe haven for niggas. Niggas used to come over here to get away from the hood. Now this all turning into the hood.
Yeah, but that's because everybody from the hood came to the Southwest Side.
Yeah.
So when you got everybody coming there, you know what I'm saying? Because I remember a nigga going up, nigga, my kinfolk stayed in the Carlton. I used to take the bus to go there. In the Carlton, nigga, you got niggas from every hood at the Carltons. So every nigga that nigga, it was kind of like, it was similar
fuck
to how
the Carltons, the point,
nigga from the
village.
From the point to the village to San Rafael, the trenches.
Niggas had the trenches.
I ain't gonna count
exclusively.
I'm not the nigga who started thugging in the points in the village.
That was a little later, though.
I ain't gonna speak on that, but.
Yeah.
Boy, say, that's when a lot of shit happens. A lot of shit started.
That was a little later.
So you feel like with the times changing, you feel like, not niggas like specifically, but niggas in general, you feel like the shit done changed how these niggas act and shit.
A lot of niggas
like I say, the Southwest Side niggas wasn't really just, you know what I'm saying, over here thugging like that. Now niggas over here want to be woo wop.
But it's really, it's all that cliche shit though. Like that, it's really a cliche ass Facebook post that we know you niggas in high school. You wasn't even on that. Middle school, you weren't on that. High school, you weren't on that. Like, why you on that now? But
for attention.
Not even half of the all the time it ain't for attention though.
It
you gotta adapt.
Them niggas, what I'm saying, the
niggas gotta
but
adapt.
See,
niggas
I wouldn't even say it like that because it's
niggas
like
got the 18,
I would say it like this because it's a lot of niggas, like niggas will be on some chill shit all through school or whatever, but it'll be certain situations that come about that it'll bring that savage up out of nigga. You know what I'm saying?
That's
a lot of niggas.
Yeah, but if you was really, but if you not even just in no shit, but if you just outside and around people, that shit gonna come out of you before you turn 18, 19.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, you ain't probably,
like,
you know,
I know a
20,
lot of
22 just hopping off
just
the porch and shit. Because you a grown-ass man
bro,
at that point.
You,
ain't no
you get what I'm saying? That's what I'm saying. Because it's a lot of niggas that's from hoods that ain't never gang bang, ain't never do nothing. Them niggas was from the hoods. They was at the cookouts. But them niggas never gang bang, never hung around that type of shit.
Hey, but in our reality, though, none of that shit mean nothing. Oh, God, none of that shit mean nothing. You could be whoever you be. You could be whatever. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
As long as you true to yourself and you real within yourself, then that's all that matters. You can be whatever. Niggas turn gangster all the time, bro. Like, you know what I'm saying? It happens, oh God. Like, niggas I know, they turn gangster after school. But that's just, you know what I'm saying? You adapt to your environment.
But see,
niggas always go through shit like that. But
how y'all feel like? Because like you said, it's kind of like, ain't shit the same no more. Times have changed. Like,
nothing the same.
Even with the gangbang shit, like, how y'all feel about that? Y'all feel like the shit watered down, or do y'all feel like the shit
still gangbanging is still gangbanging, for sure,
it's not
different.
The same,
no. Gangbanging is always forever be gangbanging.
Yeah, but it's not about.
It's not the same because, you know, you got certain niggas clicking up. You got,
exactly.
I don't know,
so
what
it's
saying?
Not about
like,
gangbanging no more.
It ain't really like that no more. Like, as far as the whole traditional way of gangbanging, it ain't like that no more. But
I'd rather niggas just stop banging. And start.
I mean,
banging.
But shit, if you stop banging, then you taking niggas' rights away. Oh God,
rice.
Niggas got
that nigga said rights.
Niggas got a right to gang bang.
No, they do got a right, but
you got a right to. If you not in a bro, look, that's it's a community, bro. Before it was anything,
fans. For sure.
So like, you gotta understand, like, it's your right to choose that. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But you can choose
but
that.
But you gotta know what come with this shit, too, though. A lot of niggas can't take them consequences.
We gonna talk about this. We gotta say this. a lot of these niggas that's banging ain't banging for real though.
That's a fact too.
This is a big fact. A lot of these hold on, Quay. A lot of these niggas be they be around certain niggas growing up, or they be go ask half of these niggas who put you down in the set. Or who did this or who did this? How you type shit? A lot of these niggas not gonna.
That shit matters, but that shit don't matter.
But we're talking about gang banging. We're not talking about cliques. We're talking about creeping bullshit.
Which is why I say the shit need to just go ahead and die out, bro, because
it'll never die out.
It's not, nigga, what you mean? Nigga, to me, it's dying out due to the fact that a bunch of fake niggas is gang banging. That's why it's dying out.
It'll never die out.
Bro, what I'm saying is, niggas act like the gang shit started off as every nigga that started gang banging didn't start off gang banging on some rah-rah hard shit, my nigga. When I was a young nigga coming up, nigga, that shit was fun at first. But once niggas start getting jumped and niggas start dying, that's when it get real. Ain't no nigga that I know was gang banging and the first time they was gang banging off the porch at 11, 12, 13 years old, it was on some super serious shit, bro. We still kids at first. Gang banging is a kid sport. The problem is a bunch of adults trying to gang bang.
Oh, no, speak for yourself.
Speak for yourself. Like, what the fuck is he talking about?
My nigga, y'all, bro, tell me.
Gang banging has always been there before you was here, Quay. Do you know where you at? Do you know how gang banging was in the 80s in Fort Worth?
My nigga, what I'm saying is when niggas start gang banging,
the 90s, what's wrong with
so
you?
So when you first started gang banging,
when was it fun to gang bang? Niggas been dying.
No.
Niggas been losing brothers, sisters, cousins, aunts. What the fuck are you
what
talking
I'm saying,
about?
So did somebody die when you first started banging? One of your homies died that will make you bang? That's not how it worked. What I'm saying is when that shit started happening, my nigga, what are you talking about? You didn't wake up one day.
Gang banging has a history.
Of course it got a history, my nigga. Why wouldn't it have a history?
I hear it, bro. We're going to be talking about just
guess. My mama,
what I said was the facts.
Hey, but shit, back to your, like, you know what I'm saying? Because we steer all the way off subject, you know what I'm saying? Which it kind of was good in a way, but, you know, whatever. But back to you and your music, like, do you see yourself getting features with niggas outside your group?
Yeah, for sure. Like,
Got to. You got to work.
Bondi, that's in the mix.
You got to be working.
I'm supposed to be linking up with Kenny B, you know what I mean? I'm trying to get right, though, first.
And they said Kenny B.
That shit industry, like you gotta understand, bro. You gotta do what's best for the.
Look, I'm the one person in the mob willing to, well, and DC, like we gonna get out there. I'm killing any feature, man. Sorry, look, I ain't.
So you kill. So you hop on the track with anybody, you gonna kill them on their own song? What you tell them?
You got to. Oh my mama, you got to. Hey, yeah. For shit show, you got to. Cause it's just like we underground, like you know what I'm saying, like. Niggas we trying to get features with, then they gonna be like, you know what I'm saying? Even if it's our partners, you know what I'm saying? Like, niggas that over us, you gotta kill everything that you touch on, everything that you walk on, you gotta walk that bitch down. For real, you got to, because you trying to get a name.
All right, so last question, like, where do y'all rank yourself in the city? Because like I say, a lot of niggas done got up there, but ain't really just...
As far as talent or what? Like, as far as what?
Uno, Count of Dinero, Thuncho, right after Thuncho.
That's cool and all. That rank shit cool and all, but I don't really give a fuck about this shit.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of niggas in the city that's hard. Like, there's niggas in the city that's hard.
Listen, I'm not in competition with none of these niggas. I'm in my own lane, bro. I want to see everybody win. I'm not... Oh, I'm better than him. I really don't give a fuck who better than who. Cause bitch, I know what I can do. I know how we coming. Now a lot of these niggas is trash than a bitch, bro. But a lot of niggas trash, but then I ain't worried about none of that. I ain't worried about none of that though. I know how we coming.
Yeah.
And I know the type of music we make, bro. We got literally everything. We got
really
everything.
We pass for worth, bro.
Every time I say I'm a blow, talking about before I'm a blow in Fort Worth, I'm a blow somewhere else.
We Atlanta, LA.
Ooh, that boy said he put.
I can really show. I can show that. Ooh. I ain't even do all that though, but I can show that.
Mm. So go ahead and you know what I'm saying. We're gonna have to run a part two to this hoe, cause it seems like it's a lot more to be said. But shit, like I said, shit happened. So I got
And it's a lot more niggas. Shout out Double O Kane. He in Oklahoma getting that work in right now.
I just finna say shout out Instagram.
Free Tony.
Lamoney.
Lamoney just ran into some.
Free the girls. Oh, shit.
Hey, Quayla, man, it's just love and pain coming in January. It's just love and pain coming in January.
Long live hood, rich Tate. The real Grand Reaper.
The real
Grand Reaper, though, for real.
Murder K, man, long live WD.
CIP, Latai, Murder K. CIP, Latai, too.
Yeah, no cap. This nigga twin right here, this nigga. This nigga right here.
Oh, God.
That nigga motherfucking... Yeah, man. Shit, shout out Instagrams and shit out too, though.
Oh, yeah, add me on Dumb Diario. Dumb Diario, Dumb underscore Diario on Instagram. Double up. Well, I don't even know my Facebook name. Just type in Double Up, I'm gonna pop up.
Yeah, what about you?
Nah, follow me on Insta. My shit, fuck Squeezy. FVCC underscore Squeezy. And then fuck with me on Facebook, Issue of Squeezy.
Follow me at YoDC on all social medias. YUHH underscore DC. You're gonna find me on all social medias, all music platforms, Apple, Spotify, all that shit. Go
two
tap in. Go, I got
streams and shit. Go stream some music.
I got two tapes out. I got a tape in the album out. Really, I got that. I got Secret Stepper, that's my first mixtape that I dropped, and I just dropped Deceived Emotions in April. That hoe going dumb, like real. I can show some real going dumb
bro,
shit.
Bro, me and brother both going to touch easily 10K views
with
no, 6 months,
with,
no
with
no, support.
With no paid support, no none of that shit. This off the muscle.
Bro, how's your phone still on with you at 1%?
Nah, this ain't my shit. Look,
I'm finna say this nigga's phone bogus as hell.
Can you see this all on the camera?
No.
Let me see some new shit right now. Like, oh, yeah, I'm zooming in right now.
Shut up,
man.
Pull up your shit, DC. I was finna pull
what's
up your
music?
Yeah. Keep in mind, you can find all this shit, not just on Apple Music.
All right, I fucked
up. This is me right here. We got singles. This Kano right here. This is my nigga in Oklahoma. This dumb Kano. I'm my mama. You can't. Nobody in the city got a harder song than this. On some just
they
dry shit.
Do the splits on the dick.
On some dry shit, for real. Be quiet. Be quiet. Be quiet.
Well, Kane just, on Crip, Kane just texted me talking about, come on.
Hey, good. I saw Kane's.
But hold on, this, nothing. No paid promo, no Fort Worth list post me, no Dallas Global, no nothing. This all off of me.
Yeah.
And I can just, bro, a lot of people don't know this, but I done turned down two deals. I turned down Def Jam twice because they trying to sign me on some 360 shit. This was, first year was like 2018, 2019, and they tried again a year ago. I could have been, niggas just not finna do
that.
I could have been done got up on my mama, but.
Damn.
Go tap into some real
shit. But sometimes,
shit.
I'm not gonna lie to you, sometimes niggas gotta say fuck that contract and just take the exposure.
On my mama, look. On my mama, I just seen a video with Young Thug. Young Thug said he knew
right,
he took
put some light on you, cuz we on video.
And this is...
It ain't that cold, but it's not cold.
It's like
damn.
But now, if it was a breeze, it'd be cold.
Oh, my mama, if it was a breeze,
it'd be cold. It'd
be cold. Hey, man, that's Double Up Kano. That's that shit I just showed y'all. Go get that shit.
Yeah.
My nigga ain't in the city right now, but we tied in for shit, so.
Yeah.
Nah, for real.
And shit, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, man, I fuck with y'all boys. Bro. Until next time, we're going to meet again. Part two coming soon, man. Shout out to them boys,
Double
up.
Man. Mob Ties mixtape
coming soon. Go tap into some real shit.
Merch coming soon. We got everything. Star Double Up, too. She got the motherfucking Dumb Cosmetics. What's it?
Dumb Cosmetics.
Dumb Cosmetics on Instagram. You're going to get everything you need.
Until next time, gang shit.
Double Up.